السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله سبحانه وتعالى says in سورة الكهف: فبعثوا أحدكم بورقكم هذه إلى المدينة فلينظر أيها أزكى طعاما فليأتكم برزق منه وليتلطف. So send one of you with this silver coin of yours to the city and let him look to which is the best of food and bring you provision from it. With this ayah, with this part of the ayah, we're gonna have three stops. The first stop is that though they laid their full trust and put their full trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while they were escaping for the sake of maintaining their faith in Him, they followed all possible means and they took the money. They took the money they might need with them. They took with them the silver dirhams, which were the currency of their time. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us how to combine both reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and following all possible and legal means to do something. And this is understood. This can be understood from the incident in which a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asked him as saying, O Messenger of Allah, shall I tight and rely upon Allah? Referring to his camel, shall I tie it and rely upon Allah, or leave it loose and rely upon Allah? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Aqilha wa tawakkal," tie it and rely upon Allah. And in the same vein, once a righteous person asked a man who was traveling with a caravan, "Where is your provision? Where is your provision?" The man answered, "I'm relying on my Lord." But the righteous person commented as saying, no, you are relying on the caravan. You are relying on the caravan and not on on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second stop here with this ayah from Surah Al-Kahf is that though the people of the cave were in a state of unrest and fear, they were keen on having azka ta'am. And azka ta'am here, according to the majority of scholars, it may mean the best of food or the halal and lawful food. As their people used to slaughter animals in the name of their false gods or tyrant rulers, they wanted to keep away from eating anything that is unlawful or prohibited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, it was said also that azka ta'am means the cheapest ta'am in reference to the price of that ta'am. So all these are useful faith-related psychological and economic lessons that we need to learn and to practice. And the third stop here is that they called the food rizq. They called it rizq. And this is because though they had the money on them and the market was accessible, they didn't forget that. They didn't forget the fact that this was a rizq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the provider and sustainer of all. And this reminds us of Prophet Yusuf sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Surah Yusuf, when he drew the attention of his two jailmates to this fact, when he said, لا يأتيكما طعام ترزقانه إلا نبأتكما بتأويله قبل أن يأتيكما. You will not receive food that is provided to you, except that I will inform you of its interpretation before it comes to you. And also the Quran repeatedly draws our attention to the fact that it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who provides for us everything, the plants, the fruits, and even the water that comes down from the sky. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us all from among those who listen to what's said and follow the best of it. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.